Mr. Salil Kumar Sharma. Sir is qualified as MBA as Human Resource Management from Jivaji University, Gwalior, in the year 1994. Sir is an HR professional with 20 years of versatile experience in employee life cycle across multiple geographies and verticals, with proven expertise of concept of implementation and of various management mandates at ground level. Sir has got a strong exposure in manufacturing HR areas, instrumental in setting up new facilities and putting up best people practices and processes for effective HR operations, and thus working as manufacturing HR head for mobile division for Intex Technologies India Limited. I now request sir to light within us a lamp of knowledge through this platform of Adhishthan 2017.
Organizations are built based on culture, and which I see is a big change currently which is taking place in industry. I'll not go by routine HR subjects, routine HR topics. I have a presentation later on which I'll share. Before that, I'd like to share on two areas. One is culture and second is your preparedness for getting into a corporate world. Culture as an organization is seen differently. Culture, when I sit on your side, I see it differently. In HR, you are supposed to, I was told that there is a mixed students from human resource background, human resource stream also, marketing stream also, and finance also?
Yes.
Okay. So there are few things which I would like to pinpoint, or I would like to touch very basic things. First is, how many of you do you agree that culture can be built or can be driven, or culture cannot be changed? How many of you believe that culture can be built or driven? Do you agree with me? Okay. Now, with changing environment, with changing business requirements, changing technology, changing generation, the culture which is getting changed now has never been earlier. Now, every 3-4 years, we see a different breed of talent, different breed of students coming in. Earlier in our days, we were more working on discipline, or I would say specialization kind of thing, or few things which were, we felt that they are right. We wanted people to be very much systematic, very much rule book based. But now what we are finding, industry in itself is requires people who are versatile, who are ready to take challenges, who are ready to make decisions very fast. I saw, I was hearing the talk by my previous speaker. Extremely wonderful thing, corporate governance. So culture and all these things, I think he touched one of the area, employee satisfaction. So employee satisfaction is nothing but how you are driving your organization towards people orientation. So I represent a company called Intex Technologies India Limited, which is one of the pioneer company in consumer electronics in India. I think most of you would have experienced Intex speakers. Any of you have heard of it?
Yes, sir.
Intex multimedia speakers.
Yes, sir.
Those are the products initially made, manufactured by the company and marketed by the company. Now, with consumer electronics industry coming to India in a big way, can anybody of I understand you people are must be surfing or must be taking a lot of knowledge about how big is the industry, how consumer electronics is doing. Any idea how many companies are there who are manufacturing mobile phones in India? Number I am saying. Any idea? How many companies in India are operating? There are 37 companies, brands, which are working in India currently. So as management graduates, as management professionals, you have very ample opportunities, very huge opportunities available in the market, which are likely to come. The smartphone market is likely to grow in next 3-4 years by around 5 times what is today. Smartphone market is supposed to grow at the rate of around 30% every year and is likely to become 3 times in next around 5 years. So, smartphones, when I talk, you might be thinking of many brands. I think you have many on tips. But when you talk of Indian companies, how many of Indian brands you know? Micromax, Intex, Lava, absolutely correct. Only 3-4, right? Maybe 5. Just, but when we talk of smartphone penetration in India, there is hardly any presence of Indian companies. The Indian companies are working towards penetrating into the market and to beat the competition which is being given by our counterparts in China. Taiwan, all these countries are supposed to be good in hardware, whereas India is supposed to be good in software. Right, absolutely right. So they all are looking towards India for their smartphone development markets and development of consumer electronics in India. A very disheartening to know that very few companies are having their development R&D available in India. We are still depending on China for technology, for technology transfer, for development, new products. But in India, there are hardly any company which is developing their products. Recently, 3 months back, there was a war-like situation with China. So everybody was thinking, what will happen to these Chinese products? If we boycott, then what will happen? If we don't boycott, then what will happen? If we boycott, then we will not survive. Situation is like that we are too much dependent on these Chinese products because we don't have any our technology available. So that is why it is a pertinent need in India to have our technology base or research based in India. How many of you are having engineering background? I think maximum. Okay, great. Must be, some people must have some WorkEx also. How many? Can you raise your hands? WorkEx? Okay. Okay, please. I got what you are trying to say. So my thing is that when we are trying to get into organizations, we must be thinking on all these domain knowledge. But when we are students from second year are here available, who may be facing next year, maybe some campus elections, maybe going out for some job interviews or getting into an entry level career in any organization. So there are few things which I tried to collate myself. I was thinking, what should I share with students who are just getting out of colleges and who are to face the external world? So I was just thinking how to share, what should be shared with that students. Then I made a small presentation. My boss, one of the boss, used to give a very good example to me of expectations. He was saying that whenever we go for drinking tea or taking tea in a restaurant, what is the cost of the tea? So I'll take a figure of 10 rupees, right? So when we go for a 10 rupees tea, what are the expectations? So we heard that it should smell good, it should taste good. Somebody told ambience also, somebody told cost also, somebody told quality also. Okay,
I would say two, three things more. It should be hygienic also. We want the person who is serving has to be very clean. Whatever utensils he is using, he is very, very, you know, clear, or he is very, very, very clean. So, when we are taking a tea of 10 rupees, we have so many expectations, right?
Yes, sir.
Is that true?
Yes, sir.
So, the customer who is giving billions or millions of rupees, should he have any expectations?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, should there be any expectations by industry?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, those expectations are very, very huge. I give a very clear example of tea because it is a very, very easily understood. But when we go to industry as an student, as an budding managers trying to seek our careers, goals, we don't know what are the expectations of the industry. So, just try to collate. They are extremely demanding. Every now and then, they'll expect you to deliver more and more. Number two is, they are ever changing. Today expectation is something else. Maybe after 6 months they will be changed. After 3 months again they will be different. Because market is like that. It is not that company is changing expectation. It is the market which is asking you to change the expectations. Okay? Clear? Third point is industry specific. What is industry specific? That somebody may be good in, maybe you are from different different fields, different streams. So if your industry requires something extra, whereas you are trying have some different experience or different expertise, so that will not match. So the industry has got specific demands, specific requirements. Next is skill based. Now, if I talk of skill, youngsters talk of only one skill, that is IT skill. Nothing else. They don't talk anything else. IT or non-IT, they divide into two areas only. Whereas I typically come from manufacturing background into large organizations, Indian as well as joint venture, Japanese organizations. What I see that skill is seen as differently by different organization depending on their technology base requirements. If you are getting into a service industry, you must be having a service based orientation skill. Whereas when you are getting into a manufacturing base, you have to have a technology skill. And last, not the least, innovation. Nowadays, everybody is looking for an innovation mind. Even our Prime Minister is also asking for be innovative. Why Google is not getting developed in India. So all these things are talking of innovation. So organizations are having the expectations. They are every time changing, every time demanding, every time skill-based, industry-specific, as well as innovative mind. So there are huge expectations. But as freshers, what is the basic expectations from us? So there are two types. One is functional and one is personality based. I give you a very, very basic example. We hear a lot nowadays that person should take a career which is to his interest. Okay. How he will be misfit in a career which is not his interest. I simply give one small illustration. There are two type of people in by nature. One is extrovert, other is introvert, very intelligent. So so these two people. So whereas in industry I have seen two fields are there. One is human resource, second is marketing, which require extrovert personalities. Is it? Do you think that anybody is introvert can be a huge success in industry?
Yes, sir.
With in human resource and marketing function?
Yes, sir.
With introvert?
Yes, sir.
No, definitely not. Anybody who is having a natural flair towards the meeting people, meeting new people, interacting with, will find it extremely easy
to meet customer, or maybe if you are into human resource, your internal customers are your employees. So you should be very, very naturally flared to interact with them. If you are into a introvert personality, what will happen? You will find it difficult to interact into a discussion with your customers or with your internal employees, that is so-called employees. So here, that is a misfit. What will happen then? If somebody with introvert personality getting into a human resource function or marketing function, what will happen? He has chosen the subject, he has chosen the field, which is not going naturally with him. What will happen? Can anybody guess what will happen? Somebody is told he will fail. Okay, I agree. What else? I am asking what he has to do to make success. Because everybody wants to be success. Nobody wants to fail, no. So what he will do? Probably he need to flexible. Okay. Is it easy to be flexible? When you have a basic personality of introvert, so is it easy to be flexible?
No.
So there is, if a person wants to get successful in that career, what he will do? He has to make certain adjustments in his personality. Okay? What kind of adjustments? Say for instance, I need to address employees. Okay? Or I need to enter into a customer meet. If my personality is introvert, but I am to talk to you people, or I talk to customers, what will happen? I'll make certain preparations. Students, this is very important. You must understand that how things can go so bad and how you can come out of the bad situation also. So when you make preparations or adjustments to your personality, what will happen? You have to prepare yourself before entering into such discussions. And it will take some time for you to adapt to that requirement, because that is not going naturally your way. So these are certain things which I was trying to share with, explain about the personality aspect of it. Okay. Now, first of the competency which is required is communication. As a student, you can always improve your communication. In case anybody has any question, you can ask me now itself. Anybody is having any clarity, or he wants any question to be answered by me on till now? Anybody else? Okay, so communication. Here, we are not talking of a communication simple by talking, or I would say it is like into a communication which gives your intent. It clarifies what you are thinking or what is your thought process. If as a manager, as a engineer, or as a professional, you are not able to communicate your thoughts, your knowledge will be of no use. So when you are getting into a discussion, when you are preparing yourself for campus or for job interviews and all that, you need to work on this aspect very, very thoroughly. I request all your faculty members also to work on this where there is any scope for improvement, because that is the area which comes as a first interface when you are talking to your recruiters or your prospective employers. Unless you have a very good communication, the things may go other way. Okay. Now, I see lot of things are like my previous speaker, he was sharing some information on corporate fraud or corporate governance. So these are the things which may not be taught in your curriculum, which you gain from your
experience by interacting, by interaction with your professors, your teachers, your counterparts or your seniors or your alumni, how to go your knowledge beyond your textbook. So as a prospective employer, they must be looking or they will be looking towards your interest and knowledge which is beyond your textbook. Nowadays, many organizations are conducting GDs also. What is that? This only, to check your knowledge beyond your textbooks. Do you agree with me or I am not making any? Do you agree with me? Okay. So companies are always seeking brains who come up with innovative ideas. You can be their ideal candidate if you prove them your true wealth by way of your experience and knowledge beyond your textbooks. So what are you doing about it? Can anybody tell how are they getting updated beyond your textbooks? Any one person can tell me. What are you doing to update your knowledge beyond your textbooks? Newspapers, okay, one part. What else?
Library.
Do anybody has a habit of reading books from your library?
Yes.
On regular basis?
Yes.
Okay. What kind of books have you read?
Fiction.
Anybody? Has anybody read the book? I don't know whether it is available in your library. Has anybody read the book called Blink? B-L-I-N-K, Blink. Anybody? Anybody that side? So I would suggest you to read that book, definitely. I am forgetting the name of the author. It is a book basically which is on timing. Whether the timing is how important the role the timing plays in your development. So I would suggest you to please, you can look at your ebook also on Google and all that. A book called Blink. It is gone into, I think, 3 volumes. Volume 1, Volume 2, Volume 3. Just go through it. Now, what else? Is leadership a born trait or it is can be developed also? Anybody from that side? Is leadership developed or it is a born? Develop. How do you develop it?
Experience.
I saw this program being conducted by your faculty or your institute, which is allowing you to perform. I saw a lot of young children very smartly moving, trying to organize things. Try to ensure that things go as per plan. There is no gap in the thought process, in the plan. There is no gap in the schedule. So what all it suggests? It suggests that you are trying to build organization ability to organize things. That is very important. That is the first step towards leadership. If we have led any small campaign in our organization, in our schools, in our colleges, that is very important because that is the first step towards leadership. That will take you long way when you get into a corporate organizations or big organizations. So all of you must think and work on those areas. Try to be the organizer of events. Try to be the organization of activities. That will help you in developing. Somebody told, no, leadership can be developed. So that will help you to develop your leadership abilities. Otherwise, nobody would like to. There is always a threat of career, there's a term called I'm forgetting the term, but that is called when you reach a level, that is a final career. Beyond that, the person cannot grow if there is lack of leadership abilities. So all of you must try to develop from very first day your abilities to
lead. Leadership skills are sure to be counted as a plus point in your management job interviews. You try to tell stories about the successful organization of certain event in your society, in your schools, in your colleges. That will give a certain glimpse of your leadership abilities. I think, do you agree with me? So what are the leadership, some gestures of leadership? Posture, eye contact, gestures with hands and arms, speech and tone of voice. These are the certain very basic, whatever came. You will not find these things in any Google or any anywhere in the web. Whatever came to my mind, I just tried to work it out and start writing on these areas. So these are purely based on my experience. This is nothing related to anything which is available in books. So, any question on leadership? Leadership in itself is a big subject. In case you want anything about it, you can read a book on leadership that is called Leadership Pipeline. Anybody read that book? Leadership Pipeline. Has anybody heard of this book? This is a book by Ram Charan. Ram Charan is a well-known US author. You can always find this book on web also, Leadership Pipeline. It's a wonderful book on leadership. It says a lot about how people can transform their leadership as they grow. From department managers to functional managers to CEOs to promoters, what is the change in leadership they need to make? So since we are talking at a very elementary level of leadership, so I would request all of you, suggest you to please go through that book, Leadership Pipeline by Ram Charan. Okay? Next is what? Positive approach. If you are working in large organizations with manufacturing background, what you will find is that the job of a manager is very, very tough. One thing, you have to manage your work also. Second thing, you have to work for your team also. Can you tell me what is the span of control which is good? How many people a person can directly control? Any idea? Direct control. You are quite correct. 5 to 7 employees. If it is beyond that, he is not doing justice with his role. Because I need to give the work also to them. Not only manager is not my position, it is by the role. If you go by Japanese concept, every person has got a primary role and secondary role. Primary role is that what is expected directly from you as output. Second thing is that what your team members do. So the role of manager or the work of manager is not the sum total of the employee's work, then it is a manager's work. That is not the work, that is not expected. In our company, there was a Japanese called Murayama. He came to our organization. He asked the person, "What do you do?" He told, "I manages my people." He again asked a question. No, I am asking, "What do you do?" He says, "No, I get the work done out of them." He said, No, that is your boss's job. What do you do?" So, there is a primary responsibility associated to every manager, whether it is any stream. I am not talking of a stream. Here it is basically, we are talking of entry level things. So, the responsibility of manager is to lead and also to guide people. To work in environments like that of factories or engineering units where there is a possibility of daily challenges in management, you need to possess courage and a strong responsibility sense. Because some of your actions will have a larger impact.
When as a manager, you go, people look at you. They try to emulate you. Whether how my boss is behaving. Do you agree that people respect what? Talent or position? Anybody is having different opinion? Whether people respect talent or position?
Talent.
Absolute. People expect respect talent. So as a manager, if I am not able to give solution to problems faced by my team members, they will not respect me. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Is it correct or not?
Yes, sir.
So what will happen if I am likely to miserably fail in my deliverance if I am not able to give solutions to my team members? And I'll gain respect only when I am able to solve their problems. So, positive approach, there will be a man management challenges asking for immediate resolution and thinking on your feet. Has anybody heard about this thinking on your feet? In your any of the subject or any of the thing? Can anybody raise a hand? Anybody heard of the term called thinking on your feet? I think you can always look at this and find what is thinking on your feet. Thinking on your feet is basically when you have to decide without any support system. When you have to decide immediately. When there is no support system available and when you are to decide on certain things, that is called thinking on your feet. There is a whole, I think, lot of iterations, lot of interpretations available in the book. If you will Google, you will find what is thinking on your feet means. So that is when you do find yourself faced with unexpected questions and debate, you will be ready to draw on these tactics and preparations. And so stay positive while you compose your thoughts and prepare your response. So it is very important that thinking on your feet means your response have to be very, very from your inside. Now, here it comes the update with latest technologies. Initially, I shared that nowadays two things are understood. One is IT skills, where other is non-IT skills. So whereas in every field, there are certain skills associated. So what is available? How do you update yourself in terms of technology? You must be prepared to upgrade your skills to match the latest in technology. This rule particularly is applicable to professionals working with IT or enabled services, where technology changes so fast that if you are not updated, you will find danger of being obsolete in the industry. In the management field, you cannot afford to be lazy or lethargic, as may account to your losing a job and your only means of making the livelihood. If you are not updating yourself, is it as crude as that? So updating yourself is very important, whether it is marketing, finance, human resource also, any stream. Nowadays, everybody is talking of automation of services. So has anybody thought of that, how HR automation they are going to drive? People from human resource background, I'll expect them to be very, 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 very proactive in study these subjects of how to be proactive in HR automation. Because marketing, finance anyway is already very, very highly automated field in itself. Because a lot of it deals with numbers and all that, so it is highly automated in itself. But human resource, there is still a lot of scope in automating the HR processes and systems. So I suggest your HR people with human resource stream to go through and find various ways of automation available. So what is knowledge of foreign languages?
So have you ever been to during your 12th examinations or when you were in school, was there any subject of German or Spanish or French? Was there? I think everybody has got. I understood what you are trying to say. So what is important is that while you are building on those, so as management students also, we need to build on that. It is not that you have left it after 12th. Since there is going to be no examinations, let us forget it. It is not that way. Try to build and find a way to update yourself with respect to your knowledge on foreign languages. With lot of multinational coming into India, with lot of foreign investment getting into India, the demand for knowledge of foreign languages, especially Japanese and Chinese, is very, very huge. You won't believe, we were looking for a Chinese interpreter in Delhi some time back. We were not able to find it. They are so scarce. Because Chinese is a totally different language. It is not like Russian, English or Spanish or French. It is totally different. We found that there are hardly any professionals available in Delhi area, such a big industrial or corporate hub. So there also the number of available professionals in Chinese language are, you can count on fingers. As you grow in your career, after 5 years or 6 years, there is expectation to deliver from very first day. Initially, in your first or second year of your career, you will find things to be very, very, you know, you will be able to make things happen with the support of people. But after, maybe once you cross the entry level career, after 5-6 years, there will be expectation will be huge. In industry, the world is very, 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 very clear. The world is very, very clear. Either perform or perish. There is no third thing which will take place. So there is nothing called journalist or nothing called depending on a single trait, single skill. So everybody is looking for general management skill. People who are growing to a career, they are looking to, they have been very good in multitasking, general management skills, some knowledge of finance also, some knowledge of marketing also, some knowledge of human resources also, some knowledge of IT also. So that is the world is like that. If you want to thrive or build on only one skill, the chances are there that after few years, that skill will not be available, will be no more required. You will find yourself difficult to sustain with that one particular skill. So here we are talking of multi-skilling. So everybody at entry level itself, you should look. So when you are looking for books, looking for go through the different update yourself. So the idea is to have a multitasking workforce. Handling new skill set with existing one poses high level of challenges to be successful. It is not that I'll something like master of what you call jack of all, master of none. It is not that we are talking. We are talking of balanced. It is called T perspective. General knowledge of all the subjects and deep understanding of one topic, one subject. That is called multitasking. It is not that I am not good at anything else, but I know everything. That will not work. That only thing will work that you have knowledge of everything and one subject you are having a deep knowledge. People who are working in financials and all that, somebody may be having very good knowledge of taxation. Somebody may be having a very good knowledge of accounting. Somebody may be having a very good knowledge of compliances. So that doesn't mean that if he continue to work on entire life on compliances, he will become a CFO. He can never become. Do you agree or any difference? Any difference? So with business coming very close to individuals, there is requirement of understanding the business to be successful in multitasking. Organization nowadays can't afford to provide you the teammates or subordinates for tasks that are not full time. So here my idea is to educate and share all these things with you, so that when you enter, you have to have a very firm base of what expected, what expectations from you, what are the expectations from each one of you, maybe after 6 months or maybe after a year. Here coming to same topic as I was sharing in the beginning, versatility. Monotony is the last thing expected of a professional. You need to be versatile. Knowledge doesn't go waste. It will work you. It will work in your favor. It will work in your side always. But you can be a strict boss, the helping colleague, the understanding employee, and courageous leader all at the same time. So if you don't have the, I would say, versatile nature, what will happen? You cannot be a good boss, or you cannot be a good fellow, good colleague. So at the same time, the person is only one, but personalities are different. When he get into a different shoes, he has to think that way. So person's versatility is very, very important. And this is very, very closely linked to the culture of the organization, as I, the word which I started, culture, versatile. So because you may be entering into the corporate world or the organizations maybe in 2018, right? But people who will come after 3 years from you, maybe 2021, 22, they will be the millennium kids. They would not have seen the, they would be hitting the keyboard before the very first day. They have been the generation which is totally different. So what will happen? Expectation from you will be different, to handhold, to support, to guide, to investigate deep into the personalities whom you are going to treat, whom you are going to work. So versatility is thing which is expected, like, because it changes with every 3 years, the culture. So when I was a student like you, we were not having this kind of interactions. We were not having this kind of associations. We were to take our CV to a consultant personally, hard copy. But now, that is not required in today. Now you have all the options. You have various job portals. You have various alumni associations. You have various LinkedIn. You have social networking sites. So when the next generation will change, the work environment, work culture, the work environment will change in 2021-22 drastically. So that is very important for you people who are going to be there in the system after 3 years, after 4 years. You will find that I know nothing in front of these kids. They are already know what I knew from after coming to job. They already know all these things. What will happen then? So then your role will be to guide them, to educate them, to be a good subordinate, good boss, good colleague, good mentor, good guide. But don't forget to engage. Don't forget to engage. Develop trust. Trust is very thing that which is likely to take you. When you engage people, you spark their interest, connect with them, heart and mind, and immerse them in what you have to say. What's more, when it's their turn to speak, you give them full attention. Showing people that you want to listen to them is a powerful way to build trust. I was discussing with somebody here. So whose job is to build trust? Whose job is to build trust? Who is responsible for trust building? The person individually himself. If he not able to build trust, then he is likely to miserably fail because he has not developed that kind of rapport with people around him, whether it is seniors, juniors, colleagues, peers. So here, trust is, you don't forget trust. Next is ambitiousness. So, the never say attitude. So, I give you a very small instance. There was an incident in my life, in my own life, around 15 years back. Very personal incident. So, had I given at that time, there were people who were saying, no, this is not possible now. You will not be able to come out of this. I told, okay, let me see. So, had I given up that point of time, I would have not been here. So, ambitiousness is when you say what is expected of most professionals. You need to come out of your never say no, never say die attitude. That is a basic or first or foremost skill of a manager. It is undying fire of desire that helps them achieve difficult career goals. That too easily. You need to be determined and ambitious if you really wish to be a successful manager. Yeah.
Sir, my name is Swapnil. Sir, as per the latest stats, only 7% of the millennials who are interested to join the Fortune 500 companies. So, from the Fortune 500 companies, from their point of view, what would be their strategy to survive in long run? Would they go into acquiring the startups which are upcoming?
Very valid questions. Very valid question, I would say. Nowadays, millennium kids or who are going to come in the next 2-3 years, they are more interested in entrepreneurship. So, it is like if they are going to be a second generation entrepreneurs, if you agree with me, the second generation of entrepreneurs, that is the generation which consolidates the business. You would have studied in your curriculum also maybe that there is second generation which consolidates the business and third generation is supposed to be the destroyer of business. Only 8% of the businesses sustain beyond third generation in India. So your question whether they are ready to join Fortune 500 companies or not, it is like no, like these companies are looking, these millennium kids are planning to get into their own ventures with a very small capital, with penetration, with the support of IT and all that, they are planning to enter into the entrepreneurship. So these kids are likely to be entrepreneurs only. So the people who are only looking for employment opportunities, they will be very demanding and they will be very difficult to manage also, I am saying. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for this insightful session. We heartily appreciate your gesture made and time taken to enlighten us with your words of wisdom.
Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.